name is Thomas Marshall. Became homeless and lost my job, my family and everything else. Just never bounced back, that's all.
When did you lose your job?
Like about 10, 11 years ago. Went to prison, you know, never bounced back.
Have you gone to any of the agencies around here to help you get reestablished?
Those agencies, I've been to just about every one of them. They really don't help you as much as they say.
So what do you do each day?
Do whatever I can. Out here, they just call it hustling, you know. I pick up or get whatever I can, whatever I can sell, you know. Try not to do things illegal. Survive, you know, the best way I can.
How did you come to be in this particular spot?
I was down here riding around one day, and I actually seen that spot down there.
Do people ever come and bother your stuff?
No, not really, no. Pretty much, the code out here is pretty strict.
Have the homeless ever been attacked or given any trouble by other homeless people?
Yeah, that happens quite a bit. I guess it's what you kind of call like being on the food chain, you know what I'm saying? Me personally, I don't have that problem, but there's other people. It's like out here, if you show like a weakness, any type of weakness or anything like that, they're gonna prey on that and attack that.
Do you have any plans for getting a job, getting some education to be able to get a new job?
I have plans for that every day. It's just the fact that I don't have the means or the transportation. It's constant work out here, and if you have somebody with you, like my girlfriend or whatever, I have to worry about her. I have to worry about where I'm going to get my next meal at, or even, you know, clothing, or even getting my clothes washed. Every day is a job in itself. You know what I mean?
What kind of rehabilitation programs did they give you in prison?
And they had a program in there called SAP. And that was one of your requirements to go to this program to get your good time in order to get out early. And what SAP does, it teaches you what to do on the street, how to fill out a job application, or how to even go get a job or look for a job. So I did the SAP program, got out of prison, went and met my parole officer. All that stuff that the SAP program taught me in prison doesn't even work out here. Only thing I got out of the SAP program was a violation and sent right back to prison. They basically just take you out, let you out, and dump you on the street with a couple $100 in your pocket, and you know what happens with that as soon as you get out of prison, you know. So
were you raised in Modesto here, and they returned you to Modesto, or how did that go?
I did my crime in Modesto and was paroled back to Modesto. And I never left Modesto, but I wasn't raised here.
Do you want to get off the streets?
I definitely want to get off the streets. yeah, I need to and I want to. I definitely want to get off the streets. It's definitely not for me. As I say, you know, you can adapt to your environment, and that's what I had to do, but I definitely don't want to be out here.
So if you want to get off the streets, what kind of help from society do you think you need to do that right now?
Actually, I just want a job, but a lot of that isn't society's problem. Most of it has to do with me. I have to go and find that job. But like I said earlier, it's hard to do, you know, when you're living out here, because I don't have the right clothing or the means of getting my hygiene, my shaving and all that, right? You know, you understand what I'm saying? But basically all I want is just a job, and that's about it. I have skills, you know.
So what kinds of things led you to become homeless?
I definitely didn't learn any of this from my family, because I come from a great family. Basically, the bed that I'm lying in now, I can't blame on anybody but myself, because my mom and dad, they taught me right from wrong, and I chose to go the wrong way at one point, and I'm paying for it. my race, being a black man, has a lot of downfall to it too, because I get called out of my name a lot, and you know what that word is, you know, the N word. There's for some reason people seem to think they can like disrespect me or seem to take from me or whatever, and that leads to me getting back in trouble, because I counter react. I did go to school and I graduated from school and all that, but I should have listened, you know. I should listen to my parents, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah. Well, so are your parents still alive, and can they help you?
No, my parents, they're passed.
Do you have any other family members that can help you?
I have brothers and sisters, but you know, they're all doing their own thing, and I wouldn't even know where to. I don't even have a phone number to contact them. So if there's anyone out there like who's like headed in the same direction that I'm already in, think before you act on anything. And if your parents are around, you know, try your best to listen to them. And if you have kids or going to have kids, take care of them, man, because, man, all this goes by quicker than what you think. Way quicker than what you think.